Today, we're going to learn how to send push notifications to your Android Flutter app. Now, I say Android Flutter app because push notifications are hard. Like, they're really hard. They suck. I hate them. I think you hate them too. I think that's why you're here, because they suck. So I decided to keep this tutorial as simple as possible, focusing on Android only. And then we're going to do an iOS version, and then we're going to do a web version as well later. But the steps honestly are like 80, 90% the same. It's just that it's easier this way. So let's start by talking about how push notifications work and how we're going to tackle them. If you've already seen this in the iOS or web video, you can skip ahead. Also check the links below for troubleshooting, a working code sample, and edge cases you may want to consider. This is how notifications work, push notifications work under the hood. It is so much, I know, it's difficult to understand for like a simple hello world requiring this many moving pieces, but let me explain. By the way, we're not going to do it this way. We have an easier way, which I'll show you in a minute. One thing that's really important to understand with push notifications is that there is a monopoly on who can send push notifications. So if you have an Android phone, you go out and buy an Android phone, it's really only connected to Google services to receive push notifications. And the service that we use for sending push notifications through Google to Android phones is called FCM, or Firebase Cloud Messaging. You probably have heard the name. And it's the same way for Apple. If you buy an iPhone from the market, the only way for that iPhone to receive a push notification is through an Apple service called APN, or Apple Push Notification Service. These are the only services that can send push notifications. There's no other way. Like, if you want to send push notifications, you have to set up Firebase, you have to set up APN. There's no way around it. Okay, so remember that. Now, how does push notifications work a little more in detail? Is that your app here that's running on the Android phone or iPhone would request the permissions to, you know, work with notifications, and would also generate what's known as a push token. Now, the push token is sort of like the address for this phone. It's like, hey, I want to send this letter to address, you know, whatever street number or you know, postal code. That's what the push token is. So you need this push token to send a notification. Your app would generate this token, and you need this token in your server when you're deciding to send a notification. You need to pass this token and the message you want to display to FCM. So you need to know the token, which is sort of the address for that device to receive push notifications from you. That poses a problem. How do we get the token that's generated today when the user, let's say, installs your app to your server 5 days from now, when you want to send them a reminder, you know, a few days later? That means, unfortunately, you need to have this difficult structure of having an endpoint to receive the token from your app in a secure way, storing it in a database, and then figuring out how to retrieve that to send the notification to the user. I know, it's just so much. I don't know why it's so complicated. I wish they just expose the way, like FCM or APN, just expose the way to say, hey, I want user A to get a notification. Well, fear not. We're not going to do it this way. This will take days to figure out. We're going to do it the easy way. So the easy way is that we're going to use Notification API. And I work with Notification API. I may be biased, but I honestly believe that it's the simplest way to implement push notifications on the market. I have not seen anything simpler than this. As I said, you still need a FCM and APN. There's no way around that. You need to integrate this with Notification API, which is done through our dashboard in a few clicks. And then all you need to do is saying, hey, user A needs to receive this message. Over here, how we're going to tackle it is that we're going to first set up FCM and APN. In this tutorial, we're going to focus on FCM because we just want to get the Android version working. And then we're going to create our Notification API account and configure the connection to these services. And then we're going to install our SDK in the app. for it to request the permissions, generate the token and stuff. By the way, when you're using Notification API, everything here is still happening. It's just under the hood. So tokens will be generated. It will be saved in our servers and refreshed at the right time. And that's it. So we go from a sort of a 5-6-step process to a 3-step process. Let's get started. So as I said, the first thing is figuring out FCM. I'm gonna start with a clean new project. So create a Firebase project, but you probably already have one. Flutter notifications demo. Now we have our new project ready. We don't touch it right now, but in just a minute, we'll go to the settings page, the project settings, and we'll need some information from here. So that's our FCM. Let's hook up Notification API to FCM. You just go to notificationapi.com, sign up. There's a big free tier. You don't need to worry about payment. It doesn't require a credit card. And this is what you see when you sign up. So what you need to do to get started is you create a notification. Let's call it Hello World Notification. This is just a title for the type of notification you want to send. Make sure you pick mobile push. And over here in the mobile integration, that's where we want to go to hook up Android FCM. Now you notice that it requires a service account JSON. And as I mentioned, for the Firebase, back in our project settings, in the Firebase console, you can go to service accounts and you can generate a new private key, which essentially would go here. Now watch out, this private key, you should keep it private, except to give access to services like Notification API to access your Firebase. Make sure it's not in your GitHub repo, it's not shared with anybody else. We can see that when we try to generate, you get this same note to keep it secret. Let's generate the key. It'll give you a file and you open the file in your editor and copy paste the contents here. Now I'm gonna do that without you seeing. So with that done, we have completed these two steps already. And there's really one and a half more steps remaining, and that's getting the SDK to work and also our Android connecting correctly to your Google Firebase account. So let's get to that. Now for my Flutter application, I'm gonna use the Flutter VS Code extension to generate a new empty demo project. I'm gonna call it Flutter Notifications Demo. We need to do two little things here. One is set up Google services. You may have already done this if you've been using like Firebase extensively in your app. And also we need to use the Notification API SDK. Let's start with the FCM part, getting Firebase integrated in the code base, which you may have already done. So it may be easy. We go back to the Firebase console. We go to the settings section, which is here, and we go to the general tab. And over here, you see your apps. And we're working on an Android app, so we add Android. And we have our Android package name here. Now, this is pretty important for testing purposes. It could be whatever you got from your Flutter package, which is usually, you know, the name of your project. So Flutter Notifications Demo. Now I'm just going to confirm that's the name. And indeed it is. And I'm going to register this application. Now, Google will give you a google-services.json file. You need to download this and put it in the Android app folder in your code base. I'm going to take this file and drop it here. And make sure to rename it to google-services.json. There's still a few things we need to change to get Google services working correctly. And it changes from version to version. You can ask ChatGPT what to do for your version. There's some instructions here but I always find them a little incomplete or, you know, different based on what you're doing, which may be confusing. Now, instead of relying on this, I'm going to rely on my very good friend Cursor to do this for me. Now, it almost always gets it wrong the first time, but we're going to try anyways because we love Cursor, don't we? Now we can see that Google GMS, Google Services was added to Setting to Gradle in the parent Android folder. And we should also see that Google GMS Services was added to the plugins in the app folder. You can compile your Flutter application for Android, and then it'll give you, if it doesn't give you any errors, it's working. Open your terminal and run Flutter build APK. And now, oh, there you go. There you go. So it's telling us that the NDK should be this version. That is because of Google Services, essentially. And we go to this file right here, the app build.gradle.kds, replace it with our own NDK version. Now, again, you may have already done all these steps if you have Firebase set up properly. And also, we need to do enable this feature for the build to work. So what I'm going to do instead is I'm just going to copy paste this in the chat and let Cursor figure out the right param. There you go. Done. And we try to build the APK again just to make sure everything is working. Now, while we're waiting, let me answer a common question people have, and that is, why do I need a server to send notifications? Like this server here. Or even if you're doing it this way, why do I need to do this in the server? Can't I just, you know, tell my front end to send a notification? And the answer to that is really security. Whenever you're connecting to some services, some important services like notification API or your FCM, you need to use your keys, your client ID, your secrets to connect to these services. And when you put that logic in your front end, in your client side, that's visible to anybody. Anybody with very minimal technical effort can look at your keys and then control these accounts on your behalf. Our action is done. APK is built. Perfect. It's all working. One last thing is that we need to install our SDK here so it all connects together in one beautiful move. So if you already know how to use Flutter Pub or Pub Dev, you're good. The package you need to install is notification API underscore Flutter underscore SDK. So I'm going to say Flutter Pub add notification API underscore Flutter underscore SDK. And it's going to get that package. Perfect. So we got that package. We go to our Dart file to actually use it. I'm going to import package notification API Flutter SDK and import the main Dart file. Now, this gives us a setup function. Whenever you run the setup function, the request would go, the request for working with notifications on the phone would display to the user, and their tokens would be synced with notification API services. I'm going to just put it here randomly anywhere, but you should do it when you actually want the user to see that notification request, probably after sign up or registration or login or something. The function is set up. It takes a client ID and it takes a user ID. So the user ID says, who's this user? You know, who are we letting receive notification? Let's call this user user A. And the client ID is our way of understanding which notification API account you're talking about, which environment, like, you know, is it staging? Is it production? So you go to your dashboard and you go to your environments or the send function, it doesn't matter. And you see your client ID here, or in the environments, you see the client ID. I'm going to copy that and put that here. And that is pretty much it. I'm going to connect my Android phone to my computer and run Flutter Run, and we'll see the results. Perfect. I have the application running. Now the only thing we need to do is trigger the notification. Now, just to walk you through what happened, the last thing we just did was install the SDK. We have the Google services working with our application from here to here. We got FCM integrated into Notification API. The only thing for you to do is send a request to Notification API for that notification to make it to the app. And that's very simple. Just head back to your Notification API dashboard. Go to this notification you created, go to the send tab, and you'll see plenty of code samples, or just follow our docs, whichever works best. Obviously, curl is very easy, so we're going to try that in our terminal. Now, one thing to pay attention to is that in this code sample to send a notification, the recipient user ID is the same as the user ID you set in the SDK, which is user A in our example. This could be anything. This could be your user's unique email address or user ID or anything you use in your system to identify that user. We're going to press send. And done. We get a tracking ID back and no messages. If you see messages here, they're usually warnings about maybe something being misconfigured. Now we can head back to Notification API logs, and you can see a log of these notifications going out. And you can pick one and you can see that it was delivered on the phone. Now, if you're looking to integrate iOS as well, check our incoming tutorial for that. It's really only setting up APN or Apple Push Notification Service that's different from setting up FCM. So, you know, you would go to the Apple developer account and do stuff there. That's really the only part that's different. And you would really want to get back here to the push notification, to the mobile integration, and set up this correctly. And the rest of it is really the same. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this.